Hey, this is Rich from Tap Tap Kaboom. And in preparation for my digital marbling class, I thought I'd show you a full-on start-to-complete kind of process of one of these kind of pieces. So enjoy. I'm doing a bit of experimenting too. Airbrushing, soft brush. Just put a little bit of this down, make the size pretty big, quite soft. Ranging from hard all the way to soft. Something like that looks pretty good. And then I'm gonna liquefy it. Distortion to the max. And then my finger's pretty good at doing this actually. Yeah, look at that. Looks really good. Just bring some of it up here. Decrease the size. Yeah. Alrighty, then no, I don't want green, I want white. Let's put some whites into here. Same kind of thing. Okay. Now I'm going to bring in some of these colors into the white here. Yeah, that looks good. Let's go back to black. Okay, liquefy this. That looks really nice. Okay. Okay, that looks really nice. And now I'm gonna add some green. So spray paint splatter. What size looks good? Maybe a little bit bigger. Yep. Looks good. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Let's go back to white and add a new layer. Just add some flecks, some flicks, some flecks. Do some smudging. Smudging is good. Okay. Alrighty. And then what I've started trying to play around with is doing the same thing with the dry brush. Just adding a whole bunch of smudge into it. And it's giving us some really nice, like, overlay kind of vibe effects here. Yeah, that looks looking good. Almost like a bit of a blur. Then I can go back to black and do the same thing with black. Give us some smudgies. Yep. Give me some smudgies. Don't want it to be too smudgies. No. Okay. That looks pretty good. And then the next thing is I want to add some noise to this guy. And because it's black and white, it means I can add noise straight here. Somewhere around 50%. And then I can go to hue and saturation and drop the saturation. And then it's got some grain, which is really nice. Still see a few brush marks here. Okay, and then I can do some manual putty-putting, calligraphy, inking. Yeah, dry ink's pretty good. And I just like to add a couple of little ink marks here and there. Perhaps I'm gonna drop my size. Okay, so a couple of little details are added now. A couple more. Alrighty. And so that's quite a moody picture, but I didn't create it with the Oriental brush. I created it with the airbrush. It's pretty nice.